In a world of depression and loneliness, filled with hatred and darkness, God brings us His word of liberation through Brother Pade Tokun. This is Message to the Nations. Good acts, but evil heart.
Let me read Luke chapter 15, verses 1 and 2. Then drew near unto him all the publicans and sinners to hear him. And the Pharisees and scribes murmured, saying, This man receives sinners and he eats with them. That is a typical situation during the life and ministry of our Lord Jesus. The sinners, the publicans, men and women whose lives have been condemned by the society, men and women whose standard and level of morality was considered low, publicans, prostitutes, women of easy virtues, they will come to hear Jesus. But men and women that were considered of high moral standard, the Pharisees and the scribes, they murmured, they were criticizing, they were not happy that Jesus was receiving sinners and he was eating with them. Those men and women that were the sinners, the publicans and the sinners, were feeling like failures. They saw themselves as failures. And the message of Jesus was pointing them to something that was of interest to them. They wanted to know. They wanted to repent. They wanted new lives. The Pharisees and the scribes considered their lives good enough and much better than the lives of those sinners. And their attitude displeased the Lord Jesus. But Jesus saw something that they were not seeing. And that is what we want to see today. Jesus knew that they were looking, those Pharisees and the scribes were looking at their good actions, their good behavior, their religious and their religious lives, and they were satisfied. But Jesus at the same time was looking at the hearts of those publicans, hearts that were seeking something that they knew they lacked. He was not approving their acts, but he saw something in their heart that was more important than the acts of the Pharisees. He saw something in the hearts of those sinners that was more important than the good acts of those Pharisees and the scribes. And he saw the hearts of those scribes and the Pharisees as hearts that were wrong because they felt satisfied, while in fact they were still sinners. That was why Jesus said, even one day in Matthew chapter 21 verse 31, the second part of that verse, he says, Matthew 21 verse 31, he says in the second part, Verily I say to you, the publicans and the harlots will go into the kingdom of God before you. He was saying to those Pharisees and the scribes that those men and women that you consider as sinners will enter the kingdom of God before you. Now, in that passage of Luke chapter 15, The Lord wanted to correct the Pharisees. He wanted to draw their attention to something that they could not see. And he responded to their criticism with different parables. First, he gave the parable of 100 sheep, among which one was lost. Then he gave the parable of 10 pieces of coins, of which one coin was lost. But the one that we shall consider today is the third story he told. Still, this story was to address the issue of the Pharisees and the scribes. And he gave the story from verse 11 of a man that had two sons, a younger and an older one. The younger one was a prodigal son that seemed to be the main focus of the story. But actually, if we look closely again at the story, we may see something that we have been missing concerning the older son.
You can order for any of the books written by Brother Pade Tokun, He That Is Born of God, Only Jesus Christ and Him Crucified. To place your order, please call 0708-552-1373.
Let us look at what he said concerning the older son. He drew our attention to him. We see the older son, but first the story we saw from verse 11 of that Luke 15, a man that had two sons. Let me read for Luke 15 from verse 11 to 13. And he said, a certain man had two sons, and the younger of them said to his father, Father, give me the portion of goods that falls to me. And the man divided unto them his living. And not many days after, the younger son gathered all together and took his journey into a far country, and there wasted his substance with riotous living. This younger son behaved wrongly. He behaved badly. He behaved sinfully. His actions were very obviously wrong. But we want to look also more particularly this older son. The heart of this older son was only revealed when the younger son came back, when the younger brother came back. Let us read the same chapter, Luke chapter 15, from verse 25. I read from verse 25. Now his elder son was in the field, and as he came and drew near to the house, he heard music and dancing, and he called one of the servants and asked what these things meant. And he said to him, thy brother is come, and thy father hath killed the fatted calf, because he has received him safe and sound. And he was angry. We are now seeing this elder brother, somebody that we have not seen before. He was angry and will not go in, therefore came his father out and entreated him. And he answered, and he answered and said to his father, look, these many years do I serve you, neither transgress I at any time your commandments, and yet thou never givest me a key that I might make merry with my friends. But as soon as this thy son was come, which hath devoured your living with harlots, thou hast killed for him the fatted calf. And he said unto him, son, you are ever with me, and all that I have is yours. Now we see this older son. His actions were correct from verse 29. He said, this many years do I serve you. I do not transgress your law at any time. He was serving. The actions were correct. But we see also his heart. He was hungry that his younger brother was well received. He will not go in. This your elder brother is an example of somebody whose actions were right, but the heart was wrong. That was somebody that was a victim of self-condemnation. He could not enjoy what the father would have easily given unto him. The younger son did wrong by getting his portion going away with and wasted. But he did not do that. He did the correct thing. He stayed back. He served the father, but he could not enjoy the father. In fact, his service was he was serving to earn sonship of the father. He was not serving the father to enjoy him. He was not enjoying the father. That is the picture of many believers under the load of condemnation, under the load, instead of receiving the conviction that leads to repentance and leads to salvation that liberates, they are under the spirit of condemnation that does not liberate them, that does not make them to be free to enjoy fellowship with God. They could not enjoy the blessings that God has put in their disposal. They have the grace of God at their disposal, but they cannot use the grace of God. They cannot enjoy the grace of God, just like older brother. The actions of their lives may seem right, but their hearts are wrong. Such believers don't have joy. They are not happy when sinners repent. They are always criticizing other people. They are always criticizing sinners. They only see the righteousness of their lives. But the truth is what? Even their own righteousness, their so-called righteousness, that they are forcing to manifest, they are trying and struggling to manifest, they are not enjoying. Their life is not a joy. Their life is a burden. A burden from which they need deliverance. They have good acts, but they have evil hearts. May it not be your case.